the Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to see how to connect a 7-segment display for your Arduino projects. It's also lesson 27 in the Elegoo Mega tutorial. Now, I love LEDs and displays like this, so there's no doubt we'll use these in future videos and explore different ways they can be used. But today I thought I'd drop a short video following lesson 27 using a 595 shift register, which we've previously used, and a 1-digit display, also called a 7-segment display, to show a countdown from 9 to 0. Let's get started. Items you'll need include a breadboard, an Elegoo Mega board, a 595 shift register, a 7-segment display, 8 220 ohm resistors, 26 male-to-male jumper wires. Now the first thing we'll do here is go ahead and put down our 74HC595 shift register. The number one pin is on the bottom and all the way to the far left, indicated by the circle on the top of the chip. The next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and put up my 8 220 ohm resistors, crossing the gap there in the middle of the breadboard. I'm going to space them about one hole apart to ensure that they don't touch. Now the pins on these resistors are so thin and flimsy, they just want to fold when I try to get them into the breadboard. Now I don't want the resistors to lean on each other and touch, so I'll use these pliers to help me keep the legs straight as I'm putting them into the breadboard. Now it's time to add the 7-segment display, and I'll do that on the right side here, and I'll bridge the gap that runs right down the middle of the board. I'm only going to have one ground rail on this board, and it's going to be at the top, so I'm taking ground pin 8, connecting it to output enable pin 13, because they both connect to ground. I'm going to connect them to the ground up at the top of the board. Now it's time to connect the output pins of the shift register to the pins of the 7-segment display. And I've created a color-coded graphic here for you. Just match the color of the pin on the shift register to the color of the pin on the 7-segment display, and that's your connection. Hopefully it's not too confusing for you. The 220 ohm resistors will be in between the connection from the shift register and the display. And while the display will work without the resistors, it is a good practice to put those resistors in place so that you don't burn out your display. Now this is a table that shows you how a 7-segment display works. It shows individual segments that need to be illuminated in order to produce a number. Up at the top, you'll see A through G. You'll see DP, but we're not using that. A through G represents the 7 segments of the digit. On the left side, you'll see 0 through 9, and that refers to the digit that is to be displayed. In the graph, you'll see 1s and 0s. A 1 means positive, and a 0 means negative. Or a 1 means that the pin is held high, and 0 means the pin is held low. So anytime you see a 1, that indicates that that pin is going to be lit up. I've seen these charts called truth tables, or 7-segment display circuit decoders, or display decoders. I took the chart from the Elegoo Mega tutorial and I put the visual to the right of that just so it'd make more sense. The 7-segment display that we're using today is common cathode, and that means all the cathodes of the LEDs in this display are connected together. If we were using a common anode, the chart that we just looked at would be totally opposite. All the zeros would be ones and all the ones would be zeros. As you can see, got it all connected together here. We can take a closer look at it. If you need it, here is a schematic from the tutorial. Here's a really quick look at the code. First of all, you want to define the LED digit patterns, and that's exactly what we did up here, 1, 0 through 9. And you come down here below that, and you also want to define your latch pin, your clock pin, your data pin. And then in the setup, you want to set those three pins as your outputs. And if you come down here and look at the loop, it counts from 9 to 0, and it does that with a delay, and it'll do it continuously. The code is not too bad. Altogether, it was pretty simple to put together, and I hope you found it beneficial. Well, that's all I've got for today. I do have some more videos in the works, one of which is a remote control car. If you were into games back in the 90s, you're going to love it. It's been a lot of fun. As always, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you very soon.